Joe's certainly in for quite the night on his first night back in NXT.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, the team of Dakota Kai and the NXT Women's Champion, Raquel Gonzalez.
And the night began with Samoa Joe back at the side of our general manager, William Regal. But as I was getting ready to say, bet we are set to showcase the best women's division in the world.
Yeah, and Raquel Gonzalez has said, one by one, line them up, and we will take them down. Each and every single female competitor, Gonzalez and Kai, have plans to take them down and become NXT Women's Tag Team Champions. And their opponents, the team of Kayden Carter and Casey Catanzaro.
A big test tonight for Casey and Kayden here in tag team action. But I want to remind you to get Peacock today and stream the best of WWE with specials, classic replays, documentaries, and this Sunday's Hell in a Cell. Well, we continue to just have to refocus ourselves here at the announce desk on what has been a chaotic night. That's been the buzzword here at NXT for the past several weeks, and it's good to see Casey and Kayden back in NXT.
Oh, 100%. It warms my heart. I mean, they've had their share of challenges with former friends. Catanzaro was rehabbing a torn LCL in her knee, but they've regrouped and they're ready for a fresh start, starting here tonight, getting focused on the future.
Well, of course, Beth, still haven't forgotten about the Women's Dusty Cup.
Nope. These two tag teams, of course, met in the Women's Dusty Cup, and Kai and Gonzalez eliminated Casey and Kayden in the second round of that tournament.
Oh, right over that middle rope, and now look at the tag team teamwork of Casey and Kayden. A kick right to the former captain of Team Kick. Casey into the cover, and a kick out by Dakota Kai, but we can't forget, no matter what we're witnessing right now, Kai and Gonzalez, Wade, still run the women's division.
Well, let's face it, Gonzalez, after that matchup at the NXT TakeOver In Your House against Ember Moon, what a performance Ember Moon put in as was in a cover.
Her into the cover, hook of the leg, what an upset this could be.
Yeah, Ember really managed to rock the champ, but again, it just wasn't enough. It is beginning to get very difficult to imagine anyone being able to topple this woman, the champ, Raquel Gonzalez.
Kayden Carter now just trying to hold on for dear life as the strength of Gonzalez on display. And again, we see the tensions still between Shotzi Blackheart, Ember Moon, even 48 hours later, the Blackheart returning. But once again, strength of Gonzalez overpowering everyone in her path. And that includes Kayden Carter, who's trying to figure out the solution to the problem that is Raquel Gonzalez, looking for the submission back.
I mean, you can see Carter wrapping her legs in this octopus-like maneuver, doing everything she can, but Gonzalez still on her feet, trying to find a way out of this one.
Carter again, and one more time, hoisted up. And Carter using her speed, her quickness, which obviously she has that advantage against the NXT Women's Champion in, makes the tag. In comes Catanzaro.
Able to take Raquel Gonzalez off her feet, though.
Oh, that's not going to work.
They're questioning the decision for Gonzalez to take a matchup this quickly after that title match at TakeOver.
Catanzaro now hoisted high above the shoulders of the champion. Catanzaro able to land on her feet. And take a,
Wow!
Have you ever seen Beth tag team continuity like this? Tag.
Well, Catanzaro and Carter have been working on their tandem offense, and it is showing.
They managed to take the jump off her feet finally. It took something really special to do it from Catanzaro and Carter.
To Kai, off her feet as well. And the human highlight reel, Casey Catanzaro wiping out the field. I think another tag was made. Carter's now legal. And again, the extra work in the Performance Center paying off. Get Casey and Kayden knock off Dakota Kai, and the NXT Women's Champion as NXT rolls on.